Good morning. I'm very thankful to organizers for possibility to make this presentation here. And I will speak about localization of convective currents. Does it work? Okay. Sorry. Localization of convective currents under frozen parametric disorder and eddy diffusivity transport of a passive scalar in the presence of these localized patterns. I would like to start with some brief introduction to what is Anderson localization, which is known from quantum mechanics and some non-quantum linear systems, conservative systems, because originally our interest to this work was related to similarity between something there and what we were doing. However, well, this similarity turned out to be nearly virtual. Nonetheless, I will keep this brief introduction, and then I will discuss what we have in thermal convection and pattern formation in dissipative systems in the presence of this frozen parametric disorder. And we'll show excitation of localized patterns and discuss their localization properties and consider what they mean for transport of passive scalar and consider some effects of some additional factors on these localization properties of these patterns and consequently on the properties of the system, on what happens in the system. So what is Anderson localization? It is known for distributed systems with frozen parametric disorder. Let me start with very simple, let me explain this with very simple example. We have one-dimensional one-dimensional problem of motion of particle in potential, which is constant in time but inhomogeneous. If this potential is periodic, you know that you have running waves. You can have solutions which neither decay nor grow. It's interesting that in the presence when we have disorder in this U, when we lose periodicity, we will never have running waves. In one-dimensional case, we will always have only exponentially decaying or growing solutions, and the mode we observe in this system are only these sort of modes. And they are exponentially localized, and gamma is a localization constant for these things. Of course, when we go to higher dimension, to two and three dimension, this interesting property will be not so much absolute. So here, for infinitely high energy, we will still have localization. But in higher dimensions, for high energy, we can have propagating solution. Nonetheless, this effect remains very significant. And it first was discovered by Anderson and is present in this work for the diffusion of spin states in some random lattices. And just to show this very simple model with Schrödinger equation, where potential U is has zero over H value, and it is Gaussian delta correlated noise, frozen. And for this case, you have such a dependence of this localization gamma on energy U. So for negative energy, it's obvious that you have localized patterns even without noise, they are localized. But however, for positive values of energy, you still have localization, and you have this localization for infinitely high energy. Well, and the same picture you can observe for other linear systems where you can have propagating wave, for instance, wave propagation. For instance, for propagation of light in the wave optics, not in a quantum sense. Well, it's still quantum sense, okay. And for the sound waves. For instance, if you compare these two equations, Schrödinger equation and equation for sound propagation in inhomogeneous media, you can see the similarity between them. So the systems are essentially identical from this point of view. And just some demonstration. Unfortunately, I cannot show animation because it's PDF. PowerPoint presentation was not reflected very well. Was not shown very well. So if you have string with point masses which and disorder in position of these masses by 10% here, and also masses are not identical, they're random. In this case, if you input such an excitation in your system, you will have this excitation surviving infinitely long. So the patterns after quite long time of waiting will be like that. So this is not only for quantum systems, but also for microscopic systems. This phenomenon is also relevant. So what we have in thermal convection? Let us consider the problem of thermal convection in a thin layer. We assume horizontal boundaries to be impermeable and nearly thermally insulating. And we have inhomogeneous in space heat flux, which is like that. Q, this is critical value of heat flux, which correspond to instability threshold. And we have such a modulation, constant in time, but inhomogeneous in space. And epsilon square is just characteristic amplitude of this variation of heat flux. And for this case, we can derive equations in the long wavelength approximation. We can derive such an equation. And here it is already specifically for the case of where Q is, contains Gaussian delta correlated noise. Think like that. We have such kind of equation. If you wish to interpret this equation also in terms of flows, specifically for the case of our specific problem we consider, this derivative of theta, which is temperature along this layer, so it's nearly constant along vertical coordinate, it gives us, its derivative gives us amplitude of stream functions. So if we have for theta patterns like that, we observe patterns like that for given realizations of this Q, the flow structure will be this one. Well, just for illustration. Well, actually, this equation we have, it is it is a kind of modified Kuramoto-Sivashinsky equation. In contrast to classical Kuramoto-Sivashinsky equation, we have here cubic term, but not a quadratic one. It's actually quite natural for many systems to have, where you have pattern selection, to have such kind of term. Because if your system has symmetry with respect to sign change, obviously you will have not a quadratic term, but cubic. And also if you have, if you consider special modulation of oscillatory pattern. For oscillatory pattern, you will as well have inversion to sign symmetry because it is just amplitude, and as well you will have cubic term, and this is just some list of different problems where we arrive to such kind of equations for one dimensional case. In this problem, interpretation, the flow shape will be slightly different corresponding to this temperature field, but the equation for the temperature field will remain the same. So in this sense, in terms of these equations, our consideration will be much more general than, this problem, physical problem I initially introduced just for illustration where it could appear. Where it could occur. Well, let us compare this thing with Schrödinger's steady state equation just to understand why we were expecting something interesting here. So this is our equation with cubic nonlinearity and non-large values of Q, if they are negative, either negative or near zero. The dynamics of this system, of this equation is relaxation to some time-independent attractors and no advection term, our time-independent patterns are described by this equation. And if we have in this system localized solution in the area of tails where solution is small, we can neglect nonlinear part and we have such a kind of equation. And I want to also recall that the interpretation for this theta, that it is amplitude of stream function. So if you compare now this equation to the Schrödinger equation for steady states, you can see that these equations are simply identical. So in this term, in this sense, the problem of localization of patterns in our convective problem, it becomes identical to the Anderson localization in for Schrödinger equation. However, there is a very significant difference in the interpretation of formal solutions between dissipative systems we have here and Schrödinger equation. So for our case, our modes are growing or decaying, not oscillating for Schrödinger equations. Our modes are actually oscillating, and their amplitude doesn't change over time. It remains, well, averagely constant. In our system, nonlinear interaction between modes is essential. It is, it cannot be removed. It's just, it's always present. Localized modes in the linear problem, in the linear Schrödinger equation, do not interact. So as long as we consider single particle, not particle interaction, not interaction of several particles, our equation is linear, and these modes, these localized modes, will not interact. So therefore, for Schrödinger equation, localization plays a crucial role in dynamics always, and actually it's the main thing which occurs. Everything else just will be about this localization. In our case, for convective system, localized patterns can be of any interest only when they're very specially rare. Otherwise, we will not be able to see their tails, and we will not be able to see their localization properties. So only when they are specially rare, so which means that we are deeply below the instability threshold, only in this case we can have some significant effect from them. And indeed, one can calculate the dependence of special density of these localized modes, of centers of excitation of these localized modes, as a function of this mean criticality Q sub zero. When Q sub zero is equal to zero, it just means that we are at the instability threshold. So at minus two and lower, we have quite small special density, and indeed we can consider this localized pattern, and here is just illustration for different values of Q, what we observe for some specific realization of noise of our disorder. For Q minus two and a half, we have in this domain already single localized solution, so it's logarithmic scale, this exponential decay, and here just noise of calculations. And such kind of patterns we observe. And it's funny, but for this special density, this approximation works very well. It's drawn with solid line, this thing. So is there some, could it be something important behind these localized patterns when they are so sparse in space? When they are so sparse. And yes, there actually is something. And let us consider the transport of passive scalar and effective diffusivity. If we have some passive admixture, have fixed flux of this admixture, the concentration profile could be calculated, and it is related like that with this flow structure. And we can introduce actually effective diffusivity constant, this one, sigma, and it is related to such kind average value. And if values of D is small, so the diffusion itself is small, molecular diffusion, we have nearly, we have very, well, in this case, in the area of flow, we have nearly horizontal, nearly, well, infinite conductivity, and some kind of resistance to this flux. It becomes purely diffusive in this area where we have no flows. And we'll have the following picture for for dependence of this effective diffusivity coefficient as a function of Q sub zero for different value of molecular diffusivity. Actually, this D in our dimensionless units, it is the ratio of diffusion coefficient to heat conductivity coefficient, to thermal diffusivity. Small value, values which are close to one, they are more or less correspond to gases, no kind of interesting effects here, but this value, which is typical for liquids, well, actually for liquids more typical is 10 to minus 3, but nonetheless it is close. We observe such a picture. We have very significant decrease of this effective conductivity. This level corresponds to the case of no currents. Nonetheless, we have here, below the instability threshold, we have here quite a significant increase due to these currents, and you can see that this increase can be by several orders of magnitude of this effective diffusivity coefficient. And actually, one can make analytical estimation of what must be this diffusivity coefficient. And if we include in our estimation of this coefficient only two ingredients, localization properties of our patterns and their spatial density, with this very simple thing, we have such a black curve, which very well corresponds to our dependence. Well, of course, for large spatial density of this excitation center, it will be not very accurate close to this threshold. But here it is quite accurate. And why it is interesting to show these things here? Just because in this case, where our dependence corresponds to this analytical summation, it means that indeed everything which determines properties of our system is this localization property and spatial density of these localized patterns. So we have a kind of pure manifestation of only this specific effect, the influence of these localized patterns and their presence in our system. One can also consider effects of some, within the our specific physical system, we had originally slightly more general equation. We had here this advection coefficient U, additional advection coefficient U. Actually, this advection is very small. When we have advection U appearing in equation like that, in equations like that, it actually means that this U to appear like that, this U should be so small that it influences the pattern formation in our system, the dynamic of this theta. But it still is not very significant for transport of passive scalar. So when we write equations like that for transport of passive scalar, we still use the same equation for evaluation of the diffusivity coefficient. So this U will make negligible contribution to the diffusivity. And only thing we consider how this thing influence on the localization properties in the system. And if we like now equation for write now equation for linearized form of this equation just for our tails to determine localization properties, the order of our system increases. Now it is a system of the third order, and we have actually three localization exponents. Two of them will be relevant up. Towards up the against the direction of advection, one will be down the advection direction, downhill the advection. So without this advection, we have pattern like that with symmetric localization properties. And here, remarkable thing that for small, for finite but small. But small values of this advection, we have very strong delocalization upwards this advection flux. So in this direction, you can see that the patterns become significantly delocalized. And it is important that U doesn't tend to zero, because if U tends to zero, this mode, which is weakly localized, its amplitude actually is proportional to U. It will go to zero. So it somehow should be small to have low localization of this mode, but not too small, because this new mode is just proportional to this U. And just what we have for effective diffusivity in, when we have this delocalization effect. So what we have without advection, red lines, red curves, and blue curves, what we have in the presence of advection. And you have, you can see that in the area where even our analytical theory is valid, so where we have our effects in pure form, even there we can have for quite moderate values of U, we can have increase of this effective diffusivity by one order of magnitude. And this is just, and this will relate it only to our localization properties and their alteration, the change of these properties and the influence of this advection. So let me go to conclusion. So we consider the excitation of localized patterns under parametric disorder in dissipative systems. We also discussed convective delocalization for these patterns, evaluated the change of localization properties, and discussed the importance of these effects for the transport of passive scalar by convective currents. Actually, at the end, this system, this problem became much less connected to the original, well, to that original motivation related to Anderson localization, because there are too much differences in interpretation. So some part of very basic mathematics is similar, but a lot of everything else is different. So our results here, they are much smaller than Anderson localization or a kind of Anderson localization address for dissipative system, because otherwise it would be something very, very big. But nonetheless, there are still some important implications of this, some important effects emerging from this, specifically for transport of passive scalar. And that's it. Thank you very much for your attention. Well, there are works which consider this system, and actually there is even works by Zimmer and I don't know, maybe his PhD student, where sorry, Zimmerman, where they consider the same equation. However, what they look at, they look at how the instability threshold is shifted downwards for finite size domains. And discuss statistical properties of this. So nobody looks at localization properties of, at localized patterns in this system and their localization properties. Our focus here was exactly this localization properties of patterns due to parametric disorder, frozen parametric disorder. Thank you very much for your comment.